was a few weeks before Christmas, and all around the town, the wind, it was blowing, and the power went down. Back at the start of December, the UK, well, Wales in particular, was hit by Storm Darragh.
Storm Darragh.
Storm Darragh.
Storm Darragh.
Storm Darragh.
This was unusual because the UK government issued a red weather warning with gusts of over 90 miles an hour expected. They even sent out a severe alert message to every mobile phone in the area. The worst of the storm had passed by the Saturday afternoon, and by that I mean the wind had dropped to about 60 miles an hour. But at just after 3 p.m. we had a power cut, and that power cut lasted quite a few hours. Once it went dark, I popped outside and made this little video.
So I'm outside in my road during Storm Darragh, and we've had a power cut for the last 2 hours. You can see behind me, it's absolutely, totally pitch black. But, oh look, what's that behind me? Some smug person's got their lights on. Oh yeah, that's me, because I've got a GivEnergy All-in-One.
So this video is to go over in a bit more detail about just how well these batteries performed and help me get right the way through the power cut. We get power cuts quite often, and they normally only last up to about a minute. This particular power cut started at just after 3 p.m. and after about 20 minutes I figured it wasn't going to come back on anytime soon. So I used the power cut app on my phone to report the outage, and the estimation was that it wouldn't be restored until midday the next day. So that was the point at which I ran around the house turning off as many things as possible to reduce our base load. So the heat pump was turned off, the TV was left turned off, I even disabled some of my automatic light automations. I just needed to keep the lights and our broadband running for as long as possible. I've got the GivEnergy All-in-One, which gives me 13.5 kilowatt hours of energy, and above that is the GivEnergy Gateway that takes me off grid when there's a power cut. And the All-in-One in Gateway also kept my solar inverter up and running. Believe it or not, for the first 45 minutes or so of the power cut, this solar inverter was actually generating about 100 watts from my solar panels. When we had the storm warning, I assumed we'd end up with a power cut, so I set the reserve on the battery to 50%, thinking, oh, maybe it'll last for an hour or two. If I got my base load down to about 400 watts, then I'd get about 16 hours out of that 50%. But I also have an old AC3 inverter and 8.2 kilowatt hour battery, which is set to trickle out power at about 330 watts. That would run out at just after midnight, meaning that the all-in-one would then be on its own after that. So look, luckily the power came back on at 9:40 that evening, so the blackout lasted about 6.5 hours. But what if it hadn't come back on? Would we have made it to midday the next day? At 9:40 p.m. we had 41% left in the all-in-one. We were drawing about 400 watts. 330 watts of that came from the AC3, 70 watts was coming from the all-in-one. 70 watts from 9:40 p.m. until midnight, which is 2 hours and 20 minutes, is about 0.16 kilowatt hours, or 1.2% of my battery capacity. At midnight, we'd have had roughly 39.8% left. The battery itself will only drop to 4% before it cuts out, so really, we only have about 35.8% left of the battery, which is 4.833 kilowatt hours. Assuming we averaged 400 watts, that 4.8 kilowatt hours would last us 12.08 hours. And if the next day had been sunny, then I might have got a little bit longer too from my solar panels. That's pretty stressfully tight, so yes, the battery might have just about lasted us until midday the next day, but there would have been no heating, no showers, no cooking, just the essentials of lighting, internet and the fridge and freezer, that sort of thing. I am very glad that the power came back on early. But I only had that much energy stored because I thought ahead and had set that 50% reserve manually. Tesla Powerwalls have a feature called Storm Watch, which automatically fully charges your battery whenever a severe weather alert is received, and it will hold that charge until the warning has passed, just in case there are power cuts. For Powerwall owners, it's as easy as turning on a switch in the app. You can manually add events if you want, and even override weather warnings if you want, so you have a fair bit of control. It would be great if GivEnergy could add a similar feature. I think the most difficult part for them would be getting the weather warning and timing information in the first place, but GivEnergy, if you're watching this, please consider this a feature request. I've made this mock-up of what it could look like in the GivEnergy app. Just a simple toggle switch to enable the feature, and then a slider which will let you adjust the storm reserve limit. I've called this feature Storm Reserve to make it legally generically different to Stormwatch. I'm not sure we really need the ability to manually add events or override alerts personally, but that might just be an unnecessary complication. If my battery had been at 100% at the time of the power outage, then I would have had no issues at all making it through to midday the next day, and I wouldn't have had to have been so frugal either. I could have done a bit of cooking, maybe had the heating on for an hour or so it would have made a real difference. So what do you think? Let me know down in the comments if you think Storm Reserve is a good idea or not. A massive thank you to my channel members listed over here, which is different to normal because they're normally over there, for supporting my channel. If you'd like to become a member too, then please check out the link down in the description. Don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe to my channel for free to see more from me. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.